class of 2013, Nicole Evans and Stephanie Richardson.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the administration, the faculty, staff, board members, students, parents, and distinguished alumni. Class of 2013, it is finally our time. We have sat in these seats for the past 3 years, watching this wonderful ceremony and watching our friends walk across this stage. Today, as we finally get our chance to take the stage, we walk together as one family. We have been with each other through the good and the bad times, and today, the celebration of our community, of our class, culminates in the 2013 Honors Convocation.
So, why are we here? Taken quite literally, Nicole and I are up here speaking to all of you simply because of academic success. However, this is not what we mean at all. We are not up here to tell you all about ourselves and our achievements because honestly, our own individual stories really are not that important. This group of young women in front of me has never been merely a group of individuals. Sure, we came to school, small, timid freshmen, scared of our own shadows, 4 long years ago. But in these past 4 long years, which now seem to have passed in the blink of an eye, we have grown in community so much. We all ended up here for different reasons. Some of us came for the academic rigor offered by the International Baccalaureate Program, others for the block scheduling, the athletics or fine arts programs, and still others because our fathers felt oh so comfortable leaving their daughters in the all-female environment ensured by good old Trinity High School.
Participating in class service trips to the exuberant spirit our class exudes both during Spirit Week and school liturgies. All of our diverse interests have constructed a community in which everyone plays a crucial role. Without any one of our classmates would simply not be the same. Because we attend Trinity, we have 124 girls who understand us, who have grown with us, and whom we will never forget. The bonds that have been formed at Trinity, as well as the lessons learned from these friendships, will endure for the rest of our lives. Some of us will go to college not knowing a single person, but others will go with the brothers and sisters from our class. Either way, we know we have a support system between us in all times of need. There will definitely be bad times, but it's how we learn from them that will make us stronger. There will be hardships, but from our experiences at Trinity that we have learned, no matter what, it will be okay. It's not always going to be easy, but sometimes it will be really hard. But how we triumph from those bumpy roads will make us better people. As we hug tomorrow at graduation, it's not an embrace of farewell. Instead, it's a gesture reminding each person of the ties we share. So why exactly does this matter? Why should we care next week, next month, or next year? We have learned how to perform in the classroom, whether we like to admit it or not. We have learned how to compete. Everyone knows of our 4-year winning streak during the class Spirit Week. We have learned to take pride in our abilities and our power to incite change in the world, whether that be in taking the initiative to create a badminton club, or through service trips to Mexico and Guatemala, and changing the lives of the Pequeños forever by becoming the dreamers. Most importantly, we have learned to love. Without Trinity, we would lack a part of our family. Without Trinity, we would not be who we are today. Without Trinity, I would not be able to stand up here and say that I have had the most amazing 4 years of my life. As I look out to the auditorium, I see 124 sisters. No matter where we go, our bonds will remain in our hearts, and our sisters will remain in our lives. I'm confident that as we go off to college and beyond, we have the tools necessary to not only survive, but to thrive. We would like to conclude with a poem by a great scholar, Dr. Seuss.
Congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away.
You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose.
You're on your own, and you know what you know. And you are the guy who decides where to go.
And when things start to happen, don't worry or don't steer. Just go right along. They'll start happening too.
You'll be on your way up. You'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights.
And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed.
Oh, the places you'll go.